Hello and welcome to Veterans Medals Workshop. I'm Frank Foster, your host, and today we want to talk about the medals of the North Atlantic Treaty Organization, NATO medals awarded to members of the U.S. Armed Forces. Starting back in 1996, the first of the medals were awarded for service in the former Yugoslavia, then Kosovo, Northern Macedonia, and then around 2002, NATO changed their concept of their medals and actually changed the medal design, the drapes of the medals. The medallion stayed the same, sort of like the United Nations medallions always stay the same. And they changed the whole process for what they were awarded for. So what I'd like to do is walk you through the earlier medals, bring you up to date on the latest medals, tell you how U.S. members of the armed forces would wear those, and how you would display them, because there are a couple of different applications that you can do. So come on, take a look. The first medal awarded U.S. military personnel dates back to 1992, and it is the NATO Medal for Service in the former Republic of Yugoslavia. The NATO Medal, just like the United Nations Medal, has a common medallion but comes with unique ribbons for each operation. The medal itself is a bronze disc featuring the NATO symbol in the center, surrounded by olive branches around the outside. The reverse features the inscription North Atlantic Treaty Organization in English along the top edge and the same wording in French along the lower edge. The horizontal olive branch separates the central area into two areas. Atop of this, set in three lines, is the inscription in the service of peace and freedom in English with the same text in French along the lower half. If you think there is a strong resemblance between the NATO medal and the United Nations medal, you're absolutely correct. The overall design is almost the same. The only difference is that the NATO ribbon is a darker blue and the white stripes are slightly wider. It can make it a little difficult to tell the difference between the first United Nations ribbon and the first NATO ribbon given for service in the former Yugoslavia. This senior airman's display case gives you a good example of where the NATO medal goes. It goes after all of the United States Armed Forces medals and before any commemorative medals. Here's an interesting display with the NATO medal. A young sergeant who served in both the Army and the Marine Corps displays his NATO medal after his Kosovo, Afghanistan, Global War on Terror medals at the end of all of his military awards. The next medal awarded by NATO for peacekeeping operations was for Kosovo, and the only real change was the design of the ribbon as shown here, and a clasp which is Kosovo. There was also a clasp for former Yugoslavia, but neither of these clasps are authorized for U.S. military personnel. However, because the clasps are not authorized on the official uniform doesn't mean that you cannot do like this senior non-commissioned officer of the Air Force did when he retired, as he put the medal up with the clasp on it for his personal display. A good example is this young infantry captain's display with his Kosovo medal. He chose to have his medals gold-plated or anodized and put the NATO medal for Kosovo into his case without the clasp on it. So the spring butt's going to ask, what do you do if you're awarded two of these medals? Well, the armed forces say you can only wear one of them, and it has to be the first one that you earned. And for each additional NATO medal that you receive, you simply put a bronze star onto the ribbon, as shown here. So a good example on how you would wear your ribbons, this Marine was first awarded a Kosovo medal for NATO, and then you can see his subsequent awards are denoted by bronze stars on his Kosovo ribbon, and that's the correct way to display them. Of course, a Marine would do it correctly. So the first two peacekeeping medals that NATO issued were for former Yugoslavia and for Kosovo, as shown here. That doesn't mean that there are not other NATO ribbons out there, because there's actually 14 of them, all the way from Northern Macedonia to Afghanistan, Iraq. But it doesn't really matter, because in early 2003, NATO settled on only three ribbon styles. The first of these new medals was the NATO Meritorious Service Medal, established in 2003. And it's a personal award of the Secretary General of NATO, who signs each citation. And generally, he only gives out maybe 50 medals a year, so it's a very significant award for individual effort, for acts of courage, exceptional leadership, individual contribution, And the United States will now authorize the wear of the Meritorious Service Medal on the uniform. The medal itself is a basic NATO medallion in silver. The ribbon is significantly different because it has on the outer edges white, gold, white, silver, and white stripes with the NATO blue in the center. If you see one with a bronze medallion, it's not a real one. The real ones are silver. In November 2002, the NATO Military Committee issued a new NATO medal policy in which they broke everything down into two classes of service awards, namely an Article 5 and non-Article 5 medal. The reference is to Article 5 of the original NATO Charter Treaty, in which any member nation agrees that an armed attack against any one of them in Europe or North America shall be considered an attack against all of them, and each will take action to include the use of armed forces. For example, on the two medals shown here, the first one was issued for Operation Eagle Assist, and the second one for Operation Active Endeavor. The big change is that all of the ribbons now have, the major change now is that all of the ribbons have two white stripes with gold stripes in the center. There are no longer any single white stripes in the center of the ribbon. It's used in Operation Eagle Assist. The new non-Article 5 is issued for basically peacekeeping missions. The Balkans medal as shown on the left is no longer valid because the only one that is used is the one with two white stripes with silver stripes inside of it. For example, the one shown here for Afghanistan. And as I mentioned earlier, U.S. military personnel are not authorized to wear any of the clasps on their medals. Here is a really good example of a former Army major who received both the NATO Medal for Service in former Yugoslavia and the new NATO Non-Article 5 Medal for Service in Afghanistan. So what you see is a really good example of the old NATO medal for Bosnia and the new NATO medal for non-Article 5 service, in this particular case in Afghanistan. Good example of a Marine non-commissioned officer wearing the correct ribbon for the new non-Article 5 NATO medal. This young Marine's display case shows a very good example of displaying NATO's non-Article 5 medal for service in Afghanistan. This Marine captain shows the correct location of the non-Article 5 ribbon after all U.S. military decorations and awards. So in summary, there are basically three NATO medals now. The Meritorious Service Medal, which is awarded as a decoration. The Article 5 Medal, which is awarded for response to armed aggression against one of the NATO members. Can come with a unique class, but that is not authorized U.S. military personnel. Third medal is the non-Article 5 operations that are conducted as peace support or crisis operations authorized by the North Atlantic Council. It also comes with an array of class, but do not apply to U.S. military personnel. And to wrap up, here's a nice display of an Air Force Captain's Award of the non-Article 5 ribbon and medal, along with his U.S. military decorations. Thank you for joining us today for our show on the North Atlantic Treaty Organization medals awarded to members of the U.S. Armed Forces. And as a closer, I just wanted to point out the old former Yugoslavia ribbon and the new non-Article 5 ribbon. You can tell the distinctive difference between the two. Hope you've enjoyed the show. If you want more information, it's all available in our latest book, Military Medals of America, available for you on Amazon Prime.